My name is Gabriela Teissier. I work for Univision. I'm the show host for the morning show. I'm a news anchor, and I'm a mom. And we get a lot of invitations to be at different events like this. Our show is live, and we get the opportunity to talk to a lot of parents, to talk to a lot of teachers. And it's really, really nice to see the big efforts that take place. Para mí es un honor estar aquí con ustedes. Yo soy Gabriela Teissier, trabajo con Univision, soy la conductora del programa de la mañana. Y tenemos oportunidad de ver a muchos maestros, gracias, a muchos maestros, padres de familia, alumnos exitosos. And we get a lot of invitations, nos dan muchas invitaciones para ir a diferentes eventos, pero este para mí era muy importante porque soy madre de dos y mi chiquito todavía va a una escuela charter. So I'm very happy and proud about that. My little one still goes to a charter school, and I'm a very proud parent of that. But I'm also a journalist, and I am a mother. And like everybody here, we cannot ignore what's been going on in a school in South LA. And I can tell you only one thing. I want to give a big applause to the thousands of great teachers that we do have. All right? We have thousands of fabulous teachers, and we need to understand that. También soy madre de familia y no podemos ignorar lo que está pasando en una escuela del sur de Los Ángeles. Horrible caso, pero también tenemos miles de fabulosos maestros y para ellos hay que darles un fuerte aplauso. Les debemos la educación de nuestros hijos. ¡Ay, esa hoja! All right, back to our program. ¡Ay, ay, ay! I'm going to put it on a leash, you know. Le voy a poner una correa para que no se me vaya volando. I want to introduce to you our first speaker today, Corri Ravare, Executive Director of Families That Can. Vamos a darle la bienvenida a una fabulosa. Gracias. Ven, siempre, los padres de familia y maestros preparados. Love it, parents and teachers, always prepared. Thank you for that. Let's give a big round of applause to Corri Ravare, la directora ejecutiva de Families That Can, Las Familias Sí Pueden, una organización que representa a los padres de familia de escuelas charter. Corri, welcome.
Thank you.
Me voy a dar a la tarea de ayudarle a Corri con la traducción de su discurso.
Well, y'all look real good from up here. Thank you. Thanks to all of you for coming out here on a Saturday morning to join us at this historic event. Your presence here says a lot. It says public education matters. It says students matter. This is the largest public school parent rally in Los Angeles in recent memory. And it's all because of you. It's because of you. Now, we're all special guests here today, but there are a few special guests that I want to particularly recognize for coming out here and supporting us today. Former LA City Councilman David Cunningham. Thank you, Mr. Cunningham, for joining us. Ms. Charnette Clemens from the Office of Assemblymember Isidore Hall. Thank you, Ms. Clemens. And Mr. Alex Johnson from the Office of Supervisor Mark Ridley Thomas. Thank you, Alex. I am the leader of Families That Can, but most importantly, I'm a parent like you. As a working single mother in Los Angeles who has spent a lifetime dedicated to public education, I know firsthand the struggles that all of us deal with. And I know that you will do anything you can to give your child the education and the opportunity that he or she needs. Now, many of us today have chosen charter public schools because they provide a unique educational opportunity in communities that need them the most. Public charter schools have invited us as parents to be partners in our children's education and have proven that every child can achieve at high levels. Other parents have joined us today and they have chosen their district school And we know that student achievement in LAUSD has actually gone up. And that's something that all of us should be proud of. And our district schools are schools that we can believe in too. Parents, we still have a lot of work to do. When only 56% of students graduate high school on time, far too many of our children are not getting the high quality education they deserve. We have 10,000 students on wait lists for charter schools in Los Angeles. We need more schools we can believe in. And yes, we have made some progress. Our mayor, Villaraigosa, has boldly led the fight to bring better school buildings to the city of Los Angeles. And you all have seen many of them being built in the neighborhood. Visionary leaders like school board president Monica Garcia has worked tirelessly to increase the parent voice in public education. And Superintendent John Deasy has created an academic scorecard that sets clear goals for increasing student achievement. These are leaders who are helping us to have more schools that we can believe in. There are great public schools in Los Angeles, but there simply aren't enough. And even our most successful public schools face major challenges. Everything from funding to facilities. Public education funding in California is 46 out of 50 states. We're at the bottom of education funding in California. And charter schools get even less. We still even have children going to buildings, going to school in buildings that are in substandard condition. We've been fortunate to have brave leaders like those here today who are fighting on behalf of your kids, but the leaders who are here with us today, they cannot do it alone. As parents, yes, we want the best for our children, and we are here today to demand great schools for all children, schools that we can believe in. But I have a question for you out there. Who do you think has the most power and influence to improve our public schools? Who do you think? Oh, you know the answer. That's right. You do. We do. We are the most influential people to improve public education for our children. And why is that the case? Because they're our children. You are the voice of your children, and you are the voice of Los Angeles. You all are families that can. Now, in addition to Families That Can, there are wonderful community organizations that are part of our rally today, and we definitely want to thank them and give a shout out to them. Organizations like United Way, Families in Schools, Alliance for a Better Community, Youth Policy Institute, Communities for Teaching Excellence, Parent Revolution, Ed Voice, and Democrats for Education Reform. All of us, all those organizations, you and I, we stand here today unified by our belief that improving our public schools is critical to the future of Los Angeles. So I want to hear you shout out the word yes. Yes, if you believe that parents have the right to know how their children's schools are doing. Do you believe that?
Yes!
Do you believe that every child has the right to a quality space to learn? Do you believe that?
Yes!
Do you believe that all public schools, including charter schools, should get adequate and fair funding?
Yes!
Yes, we do. Do you believe that all students have the right to a high-quality school in their community? Yes, we do. Yes, we do. And finally, are you committed to electing officials in LA who will uphold these principles? Can we do that? Yes, we can. Yes, we can. So parents, if we want schools we can believe in now, our voices have to be heard. And we need elected officials who will listen. And we need a commitment to fair funding and facilities. That's why we have created the Schools We Can Believe In pledge, asking our elected officials simply to put students first. Now, it is my great pleasure to introduce someone who epitomizes the ideals of our pledge and has been a champion for students pushing for public education reform here in Los Angeles. Put your hands together and let's welcome our mayor, Mayor Antonio Villaraigosa.
Fuerte aplauso para alguien que personifica los ideales de este compromiso, apoyando reformas en la educación pública en Los Ángeles, nuestro alcalde, Antonio Villaraigosa.
Wow.
Sí se puede, sí se puede, sí se puede, sí se puede, sí se puede.
I can't hear you.
All right. We'll do it in English. Yes, we can.
Yes, we can.
Wow. I didn't realize that I was getting introduced. And Corri, thank you for that introduction. It's great to be here. I'm going to speak
in both English and Spanish because we're bilingual here, right? And I think in a great Los Angeles, every one of our kids should speak 2 and 3 languages if they want to compete in the world. And Corri, I want to thank you for the work that you've done with Families That Can. And above all, thank you to all the parents who are here. I can't tell you how inspiring it is to see thousands of parents here speaking with one voice, who are saying, failure is not an option. Families who are saying, we are demanding change. Families who are demanding the best possible schools for their kids. When Corri and the other organizers who are here asked me to attend this rally, I didn't hesitate. I didn't look at my calendar to say, can I make it or not? I said, yes, I want to speak to the parents of Los Angeles Unified School District. Yes, I want to say to the parents that you're the key. Without dedicated moms and dads, we will never turn around our public school system. When parents demand excellence and accountability, when parents won't take no for an answer when it comes to their kids, when parents refuse to accept the usual excuses, we can win this battle. We can give our children the quality, world-class education they need and they deserve. Our mission is simple: to engage every parent in the education of their children. I went to Roosevelt High School. Any Roosevelt High School grads here, students or teachers in the house? Back when I went to Roosevelt High School, we had a 75% dropout rate. It was called a dropout factory. I was tracked into remedial classes. I took upholstery. Can you imagine? How many upholstery jobs are there today? I took upholstery, and after a while, I got the feeling that the school had given up on me, and I gave up on myself. My story could have ended there. I could have been just another statistic, just another kid who didn't finish. But my mother didn't give up on me. And you aren't giving up on your kids either. In addition to my mom, I had a dedicated teacher at Roosevelt who also didn't give up on me. They pushed me to go back to school to finish what I started, and I did. I graduated from Roosevelt High School. I went to East LA College after that, UCLA and law school. And I finished there too. Parents, my message today is simple. We need you. We need you to show up. We need you to show up at your child's science fair. We need you to go to back to school night. We need you to show up at parent-teacher conferences. And we need to advocate. We need you to push. We need you to say to your teachers, your principals, your school board members, your mayor, that you're paying attention, that you will hold all of us accountable to the highest standards for your children. We need you to tell them that parents count. Parents need to be engaged. Parents must be at the table. Parents, my second message to you is quite simple. You are not alone. We've got your back. In 2005, I said, dream with me. I said that education had to be a key part of everything we do going forward. I knew then that we need partners. I knew then that parents had some of the best ideas to reform our schools. But parents need tools. They can't do it alone. They need tools to help their children succeed. And one of the most powerful tools is to be able to choose. When parents have options, when they can vote with their feet, they don't have to accept failing schools anymore. Since 2005, the number of charter schools that parents can now choose from has now doubled. There were about 80 of them in 2005. Now there are more than 200. Yes. But wait, because you have options, the number of schools in LA Unified meeting the state goal on the Academic Performance Index has also doubled. That means there are more than doubled. Another powerful tool, it used to be 5 years or 6 years ago that 33% of the schools in LA Unified were at 650 and below. They were failing. Now it's 10%. Our goal is zero. Another powerful tool is information. Knowledge is power. When parents have good information, they can make good choices. In my partnership schools, and I have 21 schools, 18,000 kids, we advocated for district-wide school report cards that show parents how much students have improved over time. Now every parent in LAUSD has access to these report cards. They can see if their local school is making progress or not. And if it isn't, they can take the report cards, march down to the school, and ask why not. But the district can do more, and we should all push them to do more. Let's make these report cards better. Let's make sure these report cards include a letter grade. If it's good enough for your kids, it's good enough for our schools. And let's tie those report cards to principal evaluations. And now parents have another powerful tool. And it started here with you. It's called California's Parent Trigger Law. Let me explain to you how it works. If a majority of parents at a failing school agree and sign a petition, they can force change. They can create a new charter. They can change the school's leadership. They can transform the school's teaching staff, or they can close their school and send their children to a better one. That's an option that parents need to employ. a lever that parents can use to pry open the door to real and lasting change. Pry the door open and keep it open. Now, it's no secret that schools across our state aren't getting the resources they need. And on this, we absolutely need to be clear. The resources to keep quality teachers in our classroom, the resources to support summer school and after school programs. When I went to school in the 1960s, a very long time ago, California used to be the gold standard in public education. We were in the top five in per pupil spending. Today, we have the disgraceful distinction of being 47th in the nation when it comes to per pupil spending. If we don't invest now, we'll all be paying for it in the long run. With California facing a shortage of 1 million college graduates by 2025, we will not have trained workers to compete in our interconnected global economy. And so to every one of you, we need to support more funding for our schools. We need more funding for our teachers. We need more funding for books and computers in our classrooms. Money isn't the only answer. That's why we have options. That's why we're reforming our schools. That's why we're demanding accountability. But we need a fair shot. Instead of fighting for crumbs, we've got to grow the pie. So you can flex your muscles. Here you are today, not just at a rally, but you need to tell the people that you've elected to office that it's time to fund our schools. When you see an initiative on the ballot that says, we're going to fund our schools, we've got to get behind it. And then at the same time, demand that our schools are accountable to our kids. Parents, I believe in you. We believe in you. I believe in your kids. I know that the future of education here in Los Angeles is dependent on you. If parents and teachers get in front of the movement to improve our schools, there is no stopping us now. Thank you so much. Ahora voy a decir unas pocas palabras en español. ¿Está bien? No hablan español aquí. No es cierto que hablan español. ¿Habla español? Un poquito. ¿Sí? Ok. Buenos días. ¡Se puede! ¡Se puede! Quiero decirles que ustedes me inspiran. Me encanta ver a tantos padres que dicen en voz alta, ¡basta! No podemos seguir fallando. Las cosas tienen que cambiar. Tenemos que tener las mejores escuelas para nuestros niños. Quiero decirles que ustedes, los padres, son la clave. Sin papás y mamás entregados a sus hijos, no podemos cambiar las escuelas públicas de Los Ángeles. Cuando los padres no se dan por vencidos, cuando no aceptan excusas, se puede ganar esta lucha. Y les podemos dar a nuestros hijos la educación que merecen. Mira, muchos de ustedes saben que mi vida podría haber sido muy diferente. Podría haber sido otro niño que abandonó la escuela. Pero mi mamá nunca dejó de creer en mí. Y yo sé que ustedes están aquí porque nunca van a abandonar sus hijos. Y tampoco dejó de creer en mí un maestro en Roosevelt High School. Padres, hoy les digo que los necesitamos, que estén con sus hijos, que vayan a las conferencias de padre, que vayan a los juegos de fútbol,
hasta fútbol americano. Cuando los padres están con sus hijos, tienen éxito en la escuela. Padres, ustedes son los primeros maestros de sus hijos. Empújenlos a que lean todas las noches. Hablen con ellos de lo que aprendieron en la escuela. Empújenlos a que hagan su tarea. Padres, necesitamos que luchen, que se escuche su voz. Díganles a los maestros, directores y miembros de la junta escolar y hasta el alcalde que se están dando cuenta de lo que ocurre en las escuelas. Los padres de familia cuentan. Los padres deben estar involucrados. También les tengo otro mensaje. No están solos. Estamos aquí para ayudarlos. Entendemos muy bien que el movimiento para mejorar las escuelas empiece con ustedes. Son ustedes que han empujado el distrito escolar, el alcalde, los maestros y los directores a hacer más para sus hijos. Entendemos muy bien en estos momentos, si sus hijos no gradúan de la secundaria, si no llegan a la universidad o si no tienen los herramientas para trabajar y ser exitoso, va a ser muy duro su vida. Y por eso estamos aquí. Estamos demandando al distrito escolar, al estado, al alcalde, a todos. Nuestros niños son la prioridad. Queremos el éxito de una educación de la clase mundial. Y no vamos a permitir las excusas que hemos... ¡Sí se puede! ¡Sí se puede! ¡Sí se puede! Al fin te voy a decir, tengo 18 meses más como alcalde de la ciudad de Los Ángeles y no me voy a fallar. Voy a estar con ustedes demandando la excelencia en las escuelas. Voy a decir que sí se puede. Muchas gracias. ¡Se puede! ¡Se puede! ¡Se puede!
Gracias a nuestro alcalde Antonio Villaraigosa por esas palabras inspiradoras. Thank you to our mayor Antonio Villaraigosa for those inspiring words. And to keep on going, I'm going to introduce now somebody that has a lot in common with you. She's not only a very involved parent, but she's a charter parent. She's a parent of a charter school. La siguiente oradora es una mujer que tiene mucho, mucho en común con todos ustedes y conmigo también. Connie Rivera, madre también de una estudiante en escuela charter. Adelante, Connie.
Gracias, Gabriela. Woo. Hey there. Gracias. I'm so proud to be here to represent the Alliance for College Ready Public Schools as a parent. Let's hear it for our family of the Alliance! Woo! Right here. Whoa, excuse me, I'm so sorry. I am so proud and grateful for having a public choice option here in Los Angeles. Thanks to our charter schools, my daughter has successfully graduated and gone on to college. She is now at Cal State LA. We would also not have great schools if we didn't have great teachers. Is there any teachers in the audience? Show your hands. Let's hear it for the teachers. Yeah. Woo. Yes. Now I would like to introduce a passionate educator who is fighting every day to ensure that all our students get a great education. Please give a warm welcome to Ms. Ana Ponce. She is the CEO of Camino Pueblo Charter Academy. She has also been recognized as a top educator of the world in the Forbes magazine. Welcome, Ana.
Gracias, Connie. Thank you, Connie. Let's hear it for Connie. Connie representing fabulous parents of all of the schools represented here. Thank you. This is truly amazing. This view is endless. I cannot see where it ends. Amazing. Thank you. Thank you for coming. What an exciting day. Yes. I am here to stand with you for every child in Los Angeles to have access to a great, fabulous school. Are you all here for all children in Los Angeles? Tengo el privilegio de ser la directora ejecutiva de Camino Nuevo Charter Academy. Go Camino! Pero más importante, soy madre, educadora y ciudadana involucrada en los negocios de nuestra ciudad y nuestro estado. Como usted, yo quiero la mejor escuela para mi hijo y también quiero las mejores escuelas para todos los niños para que tengan una vida exitosa. Yo soy quien soy y estoy donde estoy por la educación que recibí. I am the youngest of seven immigrant children. Our family came here from Mexico and established our community in Pico Union, not far from here. I am the first in my family to graduate from high school, college, and earn a doctoral degree. I walked this park and the USC campus many, many times as a young child, and at that time, I had the belief that I and any child can obtain a college education if given the opportunity to attend a high-quality school. According to statistics, my academic prognosis was bleak, but today I can say I did it. And all students can do it too. Yes, we can do it together. We can create a reality where every child has access to achieve their educational goals. It is up to us, to me and to you. Y lo que sabemos es que sí se puede. ¿Están conmigo? Camino Nuevo is an example of community schools and individuals who believe in the potential of our students and hold ourselves accountable for their successes and their failures. Like many of your schools, we expect excellence from our students, staff, parents, and community because we know that every child can succeed. Nosotros sabemos que todo estudiante puede tener éxito. As a new mother, I know firsthand the dreams and aspirations that a parent has for their child. We'll do whatever it takes, make any sacrifice to put our child in a quality school. Is your child attending a quality school? Today, we rally not just for our children, but all of the children in our community. Our community suffers when one of us suffers, and we can't leave anyone behind. Tenemos que hacer este trabajo juntos para todos los niños en Los Ángeles. I ask you to demand quality schools for all of our children in every community. I ask for the respect of parents' right to choose the appropriate school for their children. We also ask our leaders to have the conviction to keep us moving quickly and constantly towards a future where every school is a quality school. Quality education opens doors, and we need more doors open to every child in this city, in this state, and in this nation. Education transformed my life. Shouldn't every child have the opportunity for education to transform theirs? ¿No tiene el derecho cada estudiante a que la educación transforme su vida?
Sí.
Claro que sí. Y lo que sabemos es que sí se puede. Sí se puede. Yes, we can. As part of this work, we know that we can't do it alone. It takes all of us to come together to really have meaningful impact for our city. In the spirit of collaboration to raise awareness to create great schools for every community, we invited all LAUSD board members to join us here today. I am really honored to introduce the board member who accepted this invitation. A leader and a champion for education reform, our next speaker is fearless and boundless in her commitment to our children and community. She holds schools accountable and maintains an unwavering expectation that every child has the right to attend a high-quality school in their community. Ahora tengo el honor de introducir a la líder extraordinaria y campeona por la reforma educativa. Por favor, den la bienvenida a la presidenta de la Junta Directiva del Distrito de Los Ángeles, Mónica García.
Gracias, buenos días, buenos días. I'm gonna say, what do we want? You say quality schools. What do we want? What do we want? When do we want them? When do we want them? I love that I can see the freeway and you're still standing there demanding quality schools now. Es un orgullo estar con ustedes porque yo sé que cuando yo era niña, otras personas lucharon para que yo también pudiera llegar a la Universidad de California y la Universidad del Sur de California. Yo sé que ustedes han luchado para que los jóvenes en las escuelas hoy también puedan hacer lo que ellos quieran con sus vidas. Así es que gracias por estar aquí, gracias por su lucha y sobre todo, no se den por vencer. Tenemos mucho, mucho más que hacer. I'm so proud to you to stand. I'm so proud to be here to stand with you because I know that I got to UC Berkeley and USC because other people fought for me. Other people fought so that I may have a chance to read and write, think and believe. And so when you show up to our board room, when you show up to our school sites, when you show up to back to school night and you say, I want 100% graduation, I want to make sure that my son or daughter or sister or brother makes it to graduation, you are leading the movement that so many before us have fought for. So I am here to stand with you. LAUSD needs you so we can be successful together. You have helped us increase graduation rates. You have helped us increase third grade reading. You have helped us increase choice for parents. We're not done until we get to 100%. Muchas, muchas gracias. It is my pleasure to introduce to you the hardest working, best superintendent in the whole country. Es un orgullo presentarles al superintendente que trabaja más que nadie, el mejor de todo el país, nuestro amigo, el doctor John Deasy. Welcome him.
Monica.
Thank you. Which way do we go?
Now that's a person I like working for. Buenos dias, good morning everybody, and congratulations. This is an amazing sight to see so many people who care about kids. Last fall, someone said I had to do something in LA other than work. So they said, "Do go to that place up on the hill and you can see all of LA, the Hollywood sign." So I went up there. I didn't see anything. The view that matters is the view from here. Many people look over LA and don't see you. That's the view that matters. The street corner where it matters, not up above. We are here today to say that we are with you and we support you. I have been, this administration of mine has been going for about 8 months. And in that time, we've authorized 39,000 seats in Prop 39 for high-quality charter schools. And it is still not enough. It is still not enough for high-quality choice. We are interested in supporting our schools, and I am going to need help because we're going to need to run a parcel tax. That's very tough to do. But I will not support a parcel tax unless it goes to charter schools as well. I encourage you to support our schools and to elect people who care and support you in this work. I thank you for what you do, and I thank you for what you do for our youth. You know, when Anna was up here, it's not about her, as amazing it is. It's about Joaquin, who she's holding, and what we will make that promise to him. Thank you very much.
Fuerte aplauso para todos ustedes. We could not believe that there were going to be 4,000 souls joined here for the sole purpose of education. Great, great, great for you. Thank you, Dr. Deasy. Thank you, Monica Garcia. And thanks to you, too. And now, I would like to ask you, whose life has been changed by a teacher? Who can tell me that has met a teacher that has made a big change in somebody's life? All right. So now I would like to introduce to you two people who are going to talk about how we can make sure we not only have great schools in every community, but also great teachers in every classroom. So I would like to introduce Angelina Saenz, a teacher at Aldama Elementary School in Highland Park, and Yolie Flores, wonderful woman, executive director of Communities for Teaching Excellence, big champion of education. Ahora quiero presentarles a dos mujeres que nos van a hablar de cómo vamos a poder tener no solamente fantásticos salones, sino maravillosos maestros en cada salón. Y ellas son Angelina Saenz, maestra de la Aldama Elementary School en Highland Park, y Yolie Flores, directora ejecutiva de Communities for Teaching Excellence, una mujer que trabajó muy duro por nuestras escuelas. Adelante, Angelina.
Buenos días. Mi nombre es Angelina Saenz y soy maestra del Jardín Infantil en la Escuela Primaria de Aldama. Tengo el honor esta mañana de presentarles a una guerrillera, una verdadera campeona. Quizás puedo presentarla a través de contarles un poco de mi propia historia. Soy hija de una mexicana, inmigrante, madre soltera, quien trabajó duro toda su vida. Como trabajaba muchas horas mi madre, mis hermanos y yo pasamos muchas horas solos en casa. Como alumna en el Distrito Escolar de Los Ángeles, la escuela no tenía importancia en mi vida. A los 16 años conocí a un joven latino que era alumno en la universidad. Me preguntó si yo tenía interés en ir a la universidad y se me hizo como una broma. Con mi terrible historia académica, pensaba que mi oportunidad para seguir estudiando después de la secundaria ya había pasado. En breve, logré asistir al Colegio del Este de Los Ángeles. Luego, terminé mis estudios en la Universidad Occidental College y logré recibir mi maestría en la educación en Claremont Graduate University. ¡Woo! ¡Que viva la educación! Cuando comencé mi trabajo como maestra, decidí ser diferente con mis alumnos. Yo les genero un amor y un orgullo por ellos mismos, por sus familias y por sus comunidades. Les ofrezco una educación que es digna de su cultura, su idioma y su capacidad de aprender. ¿Y por qué les cuento tantos detalles sobre mi historia? Porque la señora que les voy a presentar también ha luchado toda su vida por sus propios derechos y ahora por los derechos de niños y jóvenes invisibles en las instituciones de Los Ángeles. I have the honor today to introduce a warrior, a true champion. I can introduce this amazing woman best by talking a little about my own story. My name is Angelina Saenz, and I am a public school teacher in LA Unified. I grew up in a single parent home and was often alone while my mother worked to support our family. As a student growing up in LA Unified, my siblings and I felt no connection to our schooling. I met a Latino college student when I was 16 years old who asked if I had ever considered going to college. I told him that I didn't think students with 0.0 GPAs were eligible. In short, I did enroll in East Los Angeles College, transferred and graduated from Occidental College, and went on to complete my master's in education in Claremont Graduate University. Because of my own poor schooling experience, I promise that children in my class learn to be proud of themselves, their family, and their community. They love school, and they find it to be one of the most important places in their life. And they learn in a way that honors their development, their culture, their language, and their potential. So what does this have to do with our next speaker? Our next speaker has lived this story also. She grew up in Huntington Park, Southeast LA in the house. Was the first in her family to go to university, and she has devoted her life to improving the quality of life for poor and working class children and students across our city. Les presento, I would like to introduce Yolie Flores.
Wow, I have not seen a crowd this big since public school choice. Go parents! Woo! You know, what a beautiful day. But one of the reasons that we are here is in fact because we will not settle for anything less than schools that we can believe in. Schools that your children deserve. But in order for us to believe in our schools, we need to make sure that they have teachers, quality teachers like Angelina Saenz at every single school for every single student every single year. But we're also here because we know we don't have that for every student. We know that some students get great teachers and great teaching, and many do not. In fact, did you know that Latino and African American children in LA Unified are more than three times as likely to have a low performing English teacher? That's according to a new study released by Education Trust West. And it found that Latino and African American students are nearly twice as lucky and twice as likely, rather, to have a low performing math teacher. That is not equality for all kids. And let me tell you why this matters. There are teachers like Angelina Saenz, like my teachers, Ms. Hokinson, Ms. Williams, Ms. King, Ms. Smith, the ones that mattered most. There are teachers like that that are five times more likely to increase their students' academic achievement, five times. But study after study tell us that if we had an effective teacher for every student, we could close the achievement gap for poor kids and kids of color, no matter what school they're in. But we don't. And this is wrong, and we must change that. We need a culture of schools with excellence for every single student. So how do we get there? It starts by supporting teachers early and often. We need to give them the tools and the resources to be great, but we don't. And we also need to hold our teachers and our principals accountable and to the same standards that we hold other professionals. But we don't do that either. And so to change this, we first need across the board, whether you're a charter school or whether you're a traditional school, you need great teacher evaluations. And they need to include multiple measures, including test scores and including teacher and student surveys. Many charters and many schools across this country are on that path. Superintendent Deasy, the mayor, and board member Monica Garcia are working hard throughout LA Unified to change this and make this happen for all kids. So what I need from you is to tell every single elected official, starting with your school board members, your state senators, that you demand a system that ensures great teaching for all kids. It is the single most, think about this. When you go to school, what matters most? What matters most is who is in front of every single student every day, whether they are imparting learning. And if you don't have that, you will not have great schools. Support teachers. Hold all of us accountable. And as you've heard over and over again, you need to be involved. If you don't demand this, guess what? You're not gonna get it. Our kids are not gonna get it. So be part of the movement. Demand greatness for your children, for all of the kids across the charters and across school districts. I hope you will join all of us that are working hard to make that a reality for every single child. Make that a pledge. We cannot continue to stay silent, and you are showing us. Look at this crowd. You will drive this movement. Join us at Communities for Teaching Excellence. And again, it doesn't matter what school your child is in. If it's charter and you have a choice and you have that right. Traditional, charter, I don't care. Make it quality for all kids, not just some. Para todos los padres que están aquí, gracias por acompañarnos. Gracias a los maestros, gracias a los estudiantes. Para los estudiantes. Sabemos que si queremos escuelas buenas, que lo más importante es tener maestros y maestras de alta calidad para todos los estudiantes, no solamente unos. Pero en Los Ángeles no es así. En Los Ángeles, unos estudiantes tienen de lo mejor y otros no. Y sabemos que por muchas investigaciones y muchas encuestas, que lo más importante para subir el rendimiento de los estudiantes es la calidad de ese maestro o esa maestra. Como la maestra que me presentó, Angelina Saenz. Es una persona que cree en sus estudiantes, que tiene altas expectativas, que quiere lo mejor para sus estudiantes y lucha cada día, como los maestros que me prepararon a mí. Pero no todos los estudiantes tienen lo mismo. Y en Los Ángeles, las investigaciones nos dicen que si eres latino o afroamericano, que tienes menos posibilidad de tener un maestro o una maestra buena. A mí no me parece bien eso. Tenemos que luchar que todos los estudiantes, cada uno tenga la misma alta calidad y que ustedes como padres, como miembros de esta comunidad, que van a luchar por eso. Que van a tener sus opciones, pero luchar para este cambio, para que todos los estudiantes tengan un maestro, una maestra, como Angelina Saenz. Como los que sabemos que van a preparar a los estudiantes, sean parte de este movimiento, que este día no sea el único ni el último, pero que sigamos en la lucha para todos los estudiantes. Mil gracias.
Gracias, Yolie. Muchísimas gracias por tantos años de entrega a la educación. Thank you very much for so many years of actually championing big changes in our schools. Bueno, pues ahora, antes de que vayamos ya terminando, yo quiero todavía presentarles a dos maravillosas personas. Quiero regresar al escenario a Corri Ravare, que es la directora ejecutiva de Families That Can, y también a Cindy Rueda, que es producto de las escuelas públicas de Los Ángeles. Cindy Rueda, she's a product of Los Angeles Public Schools, and whose oldest two children have attended Community Charter High School in Lakeview Terrace. Yes, yes. And her son is also currently a freshman at Cal State Northridge. So, yep, you can go far. Quiero invitar a Corri Ravare de regreso a nuestro escenario, la directora ejecutiva de Families That Can, y también a Cindy Rueda, una mujer maravillosa que también va a compartir sus historias con nosotros.
Wow! They said that there would be families here, but this is amazing. I wish you could see what I see. Woo! How many Puck parents do we have? We are proud Puck parents. There is over 2,000 of us here. No se oye. Hay más de 2,000 aquí ahora. Qué bonito que estén todos aquí en este día. Estamos muy orgullosos. Me da mucho placer y orgullo representar a los padres de PAC. Proud PAC parents, you should be heard every single time. Sean muy orgullosos que son padres de PAC. Muchos saben mis historias. A lot of you know my story. But I'm here to share one briefly with the rest of you who don't know it. My children, my son has attended Community Charter High School, which is in Lakeview Terrace. Woo! The charter schools was life-saving for my family. La escuela charters fue algo que le salvó la vida a mi hijo. My son had been really unhappy at his previous school. Él no estaba contento en la escuela donde él estaba. But Community Charter, the teachers were awesome. Tenemos buenos maestros. En la escuela de las Community Charters y todas las Puck Schools, tenemos maestros en ejemplar. They took him under their wing. They got him the help he needed. Allí, Lo abrazaron y le dieron la asistencia que él necesitaba. Not only did our son belong there, but we as a family were welcomed and we belong there as well. No nomás le ayudaron a mi hijo, pero como familia nosotros allí pertenecemos también. It was very comforting to know that someone was looking out for my son and my children's best interest. Not only academically, socially, but emotionally as well. Era muy a gusto para yo saber que cuando yo dejo mi hijo, mi hija a la escuela con los Puck Schools, que allí no nomás los van a cuidar, pero tienen el interés académicamente, socialmente y emocionalmente. I'm here today because I want every family in LA to have what my family has had. Yo estoy aquí para compartir, para darles el apoyo también y para darles un pedacito de lo que PAC nos ha regalado a nosotros. I feel that every student has a right to a good education. Yo sé y yo tengo el sentimiento que todos los hijos de uno tienen derecho a escoger a dónde pueden ir para una buena educación. I am also here to tell the parents, ustedes padres de familia, to get involved, desarrollense más. Watch your children's grades, fíjense las calificaciones. Ask them for their homework, pídenle la tarea. Hablen con ellos, talk to them every day. Volunteer at school. Vayan y pongan su presencia ahí en la escuela. Y no nomás en la escuela, pero es importante que vengan los eventos como estos. These events change lives. elementary school. Pregunten a sus hijos, a la escuela, ¿qué es lo que está pasando? ¿Qué es lo que puedo hacer yo para servir también? Your presence here today says education is important for you. You are setting an example for your children to show how we can stand up peacefully. Estando aquí, ustedes están demostrando a sus hijos y les están enseñando cómo representarse en una forma calmada y muy pacífica para que su voz se les escuche. It is what we believe in. Esto que están ahorita hoy es lo que ustedes tienen fe y piensan. Lo primero, la educación de sus hijos. If you want your voice heard, then you have to show up and speak out. Si ustedes quieren que se les escuche, entonces tienen que venir y escuchar y hablar. So, ¿se puede? Cada vez que se ocupen, ¿allí vamos a estar?
Sí.
Eso mero.
Give her another round of applause. That's parent power right there. Parent power. Parents, thank you for hanging in there. This is why we are here today, because of stories like this. Thank you, Cindy, for sharing your incredible story.
You're welcome.
And I know that many of you have similar stories. But remember, right now there are 10,000 students in LA on a waiting list to go to a charter school. That's why charter schools will continue to expand to serve more students in response to us, the parents. That's why charter schools will continue to expand to respond to us, the parents, who said we need them for our communities. Every day, elected officials are making decisions that affect our schools and our children. Listen, parents, there are many important elections coming up for LA mayor. We've got to elect a new mayor. We're going to miss Mayor Antonio Villaraigosa, but we've got to elect a mayor who will continue his legacy of focus on education reform. Can we do that?
Yeah.
Yes, we can. City council, there are major elections coming up. We've got to turn out in big numbers just like today. Can we do that? Can we elect city council members who care about what we care about? Of course we can. We can do it. We did it today. School board in 2013. Let me tell you something. There are 7 school board members. All 7 were invited. One of them showed up. Our president, Monica Garcia. You remember that? You remember who showed up for you? Today is a kickoff for a year-long campaign to ensure that we are improving our public schools and to make sure that it is at the top of the agenda of all of our elected officials. As Cindy said, we need you to continue to stand for children. If we want schools we can believe in, schools we can believe in, we need commitment to fair funding and facilities. We need our voices to be heard. And we need elected officials who will listen to us. Okay, so remember that, parents. Thank you all.